Hey, Pantano family, I hope you are doing well. I'm Josh, and I am the campus pastor of our Southeast campus. And I wanted to hop on here. We're trying to have a pastor hop onto Facebook and Instagram each day just to share something encouraging with you, to help spur you on, just as we're walking through just this crazy and really kind of surreal season in our country right now. And one of the things, many of us look at life differently. Some of us look at it very optimistically. Some of us are a little bit more pessimistic. And for me, I have always been one of those more pessimistic kind of people. I've never been one of those people that, you know, there's some people who just see, you know, the glass not just half full, but it's just overflowing. And they just, and they have so much optimism, so much energy that at 7 a.m. on Monday morning, they are so excited about the week ahead. But that has never really been my thing. And so one of the practices that has really grounded me in my faith is the practice of gratitude. And it's not something I do naturally, but over and over in Scripture, we're told to thank God, to give thanks to God. And we do that at Thanksgiving. We'll go around the table, maybe do this at your house where you everyone says one thing that they're thankful for. But in this season, as I have just tried to make a practice of each day, writing down one to three things that I'm thankful for, this season has really helped me to see things in a new way. Like, for example, I never thought that one of the things that I would write down that I'm thankful for is toilet paper. I never thought that there would come a day that I would walk out of Costco with the mega roll pack filled and I'm carrying it like a football that I'm protecting. I never thought that that would feel like winning the lottery, but it does. And even now, one of the things that we'll say at Thanksgiving is, oh, I'm thankful for my health, I'm thankful for my relationships, but that has really heightened for me right now. That has really heightened just as I think about the age of my parents and friends and family who are struggling right now or have quarantined themselves even more than I am. And my health is something I'm even more thankful for than I have ever been before. And so here's what I want to encourage you to do is to, at some point today, just write down three things you're thankful for. And then do it again tomorrow. And then do it again the next day. And let me say this, if you write down the name of somebody, maybe it's a spouse, a parent, a sibling, a friend, a coworker, a child, let them know. If you're thankful for somebody that's in your life, let them know. Send them a text, give them a phone call, FaceTime with them. Tell them, I'm so thankful that you're in my life. And here's why I'm thankful. Don't just say that you're thankful. Tell them why you're thankful that they're in your life. Let them know. This is an opportunity that we have to really reevaluate and to really look at the things that we prioritize and the things that we think are really important. And it's interesting that in this season of social distancing, we're being reminded that relationships really are important. And we really, really are thankful for those people, especially those of us who are introverts. We're starting to go, you know what? We really are thankful for the people in our lives. And so I don't want you to miss, there are so much that's happening right now. There's so many things that are uncertain. And it's okay as to engage in those things. And we want you to engage in those things and bring those to God. But to not miss the really small ways that God is at work and the gifts that God has given to you. And so I hope that this encourages you. I look forward to seeing you this coming Sunday as we are all together again on our online campus and we're kicking off a brand new series. I hope you guys have a good rest of the day and a great rest of the week.